Hi friends, how are you? In this video clip, I am going to brief you on the spinning technology, spun yarn technology. Spun yarn technology having two types of spinning. One is filament yarn spinning for synthetic fibers or regenerated fibers. Usually filament spinning yarn is for synthetic 100% man-made synthetic fibers, say polyester, nylon and other things, and spun yarn technology is for staple fibers, say cotton, viscose, rayon, even polyester. So in this video clip I am going to start the spinning process for staple yarn spinning, especially on conventional spinning yarn. Conventional means that is not old or like 100 years back or 50 years back, just what the present the spinning industries are working. See, the first stage of spinning industry, staple spun yarn industry, is preparatory process. Next one is spinning process. In spinning of the yarn, in preparatory process, there are departments, you know, mixing department, blow room department, carding department, drawing department, simplex, fly frame department, and spinning, ring frame department, and also final winding and packaging. As a first step, in this video, I am explaining on the blow room line. Mixing mixing, you know, that is the part of the subject if I required I will take the other videos, but now I will start the most important, that is blow room line. See, blow room line process, why blow room line process is required? Blow room line process, why it is required? See, the raw material, the cotton coming from the ginning factory in the form of bales. One bale weighing 180 kgs or 500, average 500 pounds. Okay, the bales of not one variety, around 4 to 5 variety of cottons are mixed in the mixing department. I'm saying this video is on staple spun yarn, especially on cotton spun yarn. Blow room line working on for cotton spun yarn. Even blow room line is used set right for polyester viscose, polyester cotton blend also. Now I'm talking not for cotton or not for polyester cotton, not for polyester viscose. Generally, I'm explaining or briefing about the blow room line process. Okay. The bales mixing, the bale mixing, bales of say J34SG, DCH, NHH4, like that, many varieties will be there. Those are all mixed. How to mix? The staple length and micronair fineness of the fibers should be almost similar in varieties. That is one point I can tell, homogeneous mixing is preferred for best quality of ring spun yarn. Okay, that is mixing. After mixing, the cotton bales are opened. In conventional spinning mill, that is at least 25-50 years old mill, conventional, by manual mixing is taken place. All bales are spread one over the other, homogeneous, to make homogeneous mixing, and by manually it is fed to the opener, bale opener. Okay, that is manual. But nowadays in modern blurum line. Everything is automatized. Labor is reduced. Labor employment is reduced. And whatever the bale mixings are there, that is done by the machine itself. All bales are kept in a systematic manner to the automatic bale opener machine. This automatic bale opener machine will take the cotton tuft from each and every bale, whatever the plan to mix, okay, and fed it to the blurum line. That is after the, that is fed to the opening of the, that is bale op, not bale opener, bale opener machine is passing those homogeneous plucking, whatever it will pluck the tuft of the fibers from the bales, no, that is passing through the next operations. Okay, this is there. What is the difference between conventional, that is manually feeding of the homogeneously mixed cotton, and in modern technology, the automatic feeding, automatic mixing of the bales and automatic feeding will be there. This is one point. And second point, the difference between the conventional man handling process and automatic, second process is, second important thing, bale opener, automatic bale opener or plucker is there, no, mixing, that is one point, that is at the starting of the blurum line. And at the end of the blurum line, instead of carrying the laps from the scutcher of the blurum to the carding machine, that is manual carrying of the lap of the blurum or scutcher to the carding machine, there is automatic system, automatized system, that is chute feeding system. Chute feeding. Chute feeding means there is no scutcher, there is no lap formation. Directly whatever the cleaned fibers will be there, cleaned micro level individual fibers are there, whatever the in the blurum, that is passed directly each and every carding machines which are preferred for particular count. That is chute feeding system, it is called in the spinning industries. This is the difference. In conventional, what will happen? Scutcher will be there. Whatever the cleaned and opened cotton is there, that is taken in the lattice, in the sheet form, bed sheet form, and it is revolved in the lap roller. Okay, this is there. Okay, now this is about the introduction I gave about the blurum line. Now next point is, I am going to tell you what are the objectives of blurum line. Why blurum line is required? Objectives of the blurum line. The objective of the blurum line is whatever the big tuft lumps are there in the bales, those tuft, big tuft, or say called flocks, flock of cottons, cotton flocks, or lumps of the cotton, those are all that is required to open. Fibers are opened, or fibers are entangled with each other in the packed form of the bale, that should be opened by means of breaking, by means of breaking the tuft. Say this much of tuft is break into small tuft. In blurum line, this much of lump is reduced to tuft, tuft is reduced to small tuft. That is stages of opening of the fiber. In blurum line, the big tuft is reduced to small tuft, small in size. This is one point. Second point, removal of the dust. Say I am telling you, first objective is opening of the tuft, opening of the cotton lumps or tuft. This is first one. Opening, Second one is cleaning of the, second objective is cleaning of the cotton fiber. First one is opening of the cotton tuft, lump or flock. Second one is cleaning of the cotton. Third one is, what is the third one is blending, blending of the cotton. Fourth one is inform fading. Okay. Opening, cleaning, blending, okay, and fading. These are must required. Okay, first objective, opening. See, opening of the tuft, this much of tuft will be there. Lump, in conventional blowroom line, labors are opening by hand. Or the feeder, the feeding labor, the labor is in the feeding bale opener machine, who is there? He is manually, he is checking, big wheel left, he is manually doing. Or in the lattice and bale opener, it will open tuft. In bale, in opening, okay, whatever the tuft are there, those are by means of spiked lattice. Spiked lattice will be there and the rollers will be there. In blowroom line, what are the mechanisms are there? Before I'm going to explain brief on the objectives, what the machines involved in the blowroom line. If I said about the machine, what type of machines are there? What mechanism is there? Then I can say, next I will come to the objectives. See, only the machine used are 4 or 5 machines will be there. And whatever steps are there, objectives, opening, cleaning, blending, to perform these objectives, the rollers will be there. Opener, there those equipments or machines or mechanisms, whatever the made system in machine system, that is called, some machines are called openers and some machines are called beaters and some machines are called cleaners and some machines are called blenders. These opener, cleaner, beaters, all are rotating rollers, drums, rotating drums. The surface of the drums is having spiked knife, spiked pins and spiked knife like pins. While rotating those rollers, spiked roller or pinned rollers, whatever the cotton is passing across the rollers, it is opened. Okay. The opener, and also here the opener roller or beater, beater means 2-bladed beater, 3-bladed beater will be there, or Kirshner beater will be there. Okay, superior cleaner will be there, like that multi-blending chambers will be there. Okay, these are all the things are there. These beaters, cleaners, openers will having spiked pins. While rotating, these spiked pins, knife like pins or blades are where the cotton is coming through the machines by through the hose pipe. These are all cotton is subjected to the opening, combing, like combed by pins or breaking of the tuft into small tuft by the spikes or pins or whatever the blades are there. Okay, so this is one thing is there. And second thing is, from one machine to second machine, whatever the cotton is passing, that is by means of air. The cotton is transferring from one machine to the other machine by means of blowing, air blowing. Because of this system, the cotton is passing from mixing zone to the carding zone through the hose pipes. In the hose pipe, a high speed air wheel is blowing. Through the blown air, the cotton tufts, small tufts are passing. Okay, because of the system mechanism of blowing the cotton, through the air. So the line or the department is called blow room line. Okay, na? This is one point. Second one is, other important point here is speed. Speed of the rollers and speed of the lattice. Okay, lattice means the lattice carrying the, in some sculptures, say in sculpture machine or in bale opener machine, lattice are used. Each lattice are having stripes, having pins to carry the cotton, to move the cotton, taken the cotton forward or to lift the cotton up or down, inclined lattice, horizontal lattice, openers, breakers, like that it will be there. These are the systems only to achieve the objectives it should perform. Okay, so by means of these system, different speeds of the beaters, openers, and whatever called hose pipe and system, whatever is there, by this mechanism, first objective, that is opening of the cotton, takes place. Second one is, opening means the breaking of the tuft into small tuft. This much of tuft is break into small level of the cleaning is taken place. In one machine, it will clean something, some percentage. In second machine, it will clean some percentage. It will, third machine, it will open and clean. Opening and cleaning, step by step it will take place. Finally, whatever the cotton is coming at the end of the department, blow room department, almost the big tuft of the cotton is cleaned into a white cotton, and also cleaning will be around 40 to 70% of cleaning efficiency will be there. Okay, now cotton is opened, objective. What is the cleaning? What is that cleaning? Cleaning is whatever the bales are there coming from the ginning department, the bales are having dust and dirt particles and foreign impurities. These are all the things, and metal parts, metal things that were small or whatever is there, and dust, dirt, small metal things, foreign impurities, dried leaves, that is cotton plant dried leaves, unwanted color particles and metal particles, small stones like sand parts, so much of unwanted things are there, it is included. So while the cotton is passing through the machines, okay, each and every machines, what will happen after whatever, how while beating the cotton in each and every machines, whatever the dust and dirt particles are there, that is falling down in each machines. Okay, now so in each machine, one way cotton is opening, tuft is opening, at the same time dust and dirt and is falling down, and in the starting place of the blow room line or in the middle, that is some metal detector will be there. Whatever the metal detector is there, anything is there, magnetic system will be there, that will catch the metal system. These are all the things are there. So cleaning, dust and dirt, foreign impurities, metals, whatever unwanted is there, that is cleaned. The cotton is cleaned by this. Okay, na? Opening, cleaning. And next one is blending. That is multi-blending, MBO, of machine will be there. In that chambers, in each and every chambers, the cotton is passing. While passing, the homogeneous mixing taken place. Because in the mixing department, not only one variety of cotton, there are 4 to 5 varieties of cottons are used. All 4 to 5 varieties of cottons are blended. So blending of homogeneous blending is taken place. So 4 varieties of cottons are mixed, 4 varieties of cotton fibers are mixed homogeneously in the blending operations. And finally, if the mill is having conventional system, that is scutcher will be there. That scutcher, in the scutcher, all the opened, cleaned, blended fibers, okay, is collected in the form of web, in the form of sheet, in the form of bed, in the form of sheet, by using the lattice systems, by using a proper convenient lattice system, the whole, whatever the coming cleaned, opened cotton is coming, that is converted into sheet form. So that sheet form is whatever the is revolve or rotate, it will convert into a what you call roller, it will rolled, the whatever sheet form of cotton is there, that is rolled in rolled. That rolled form of cotton is called lap. Okay, one lap is having around 45 inches length will be there, and 15 to 18 inches diameter will be there. Okay, that lap is the in conventional machine, each and every lap is taken and made. This is if in modern is there, chute fitting is there, there is no scutcher will be there. Directly cleaned cotton is passed through the carding machines connected. There the supply of cotton takes place to the carding machines. Okay, this is about the blorum lines. Okay, then last objective is informed flowing. Informed flowing is a must in blorum line. Why informed flowing is required? Because whatever the in the lap in conventional blorum line, whatever the lap is rolled, that should, that sheet should have uniform weight per unit length. The weight distribution in the lap should be uniform, so that based on, if the weight distribution is varied, some in one end weight is more, in one end weight is less, then the final yarn spun, it is having a CV problem will be there, U percentage problem will be there, and so much of other quality issues will come. So the weight per unit length is very much important, correct? So in tube feeding, the proper feeding of the it is taken care of, proper feeding to the each and every carding machines. This is about the blorum line. Okay, and the whatever system in modern system, what are the types are there in modern blorum line nowadays in 2021? So much of technology is updated for the blorum lines, so much of automation takes place, so and so much of efficiency is improved, cleaning efficiency is improved, opening efficiency is improved, and production efficiency is improved, everything is there. Okay, Lakshmi Reeter or 100% or Reeter, Lakshmi Reeter, BMW, and I will mention here Textile. Okay, there are the many brands are there, good brands are there, depend upon the company, what type of counts are spun in the spinning mill, say whether it is 100% cotton or in 100% cotton, what are the counts, whether fine counts or coarser counts, or too fine means hundreds, 120s, 150s, 180s count. It depends upon the counts the blorum lines are set. If the mill is working for polyviscose, the blorum setting is different. If the mill is working for the poly cotton, the blorum line setting will be different. If the for coarser count, blorum setting is different. Okay, so setting means the number of, there is a changes in the number of beaters. Number of beaters, it depends upon the number of beaters, number of openers. It is how much of beaters are required, how much of openers are required, everything is calculated, is estimated. Friends, I will come back with the other video on next department, carding department. Please subscribe to my channel, those who are not yet subscribed, and please like it and share it. Please click the icon bell for all notifications. Thank you very much.